with a maximum crude oil production capacity of 2.5 million barrels per day. Nigeria ranks as Africa's largest producer of oil and the sixth largest oil producing country in the world. To surpass this current rating, the Federal Minister of Petroleum Resources has made landmark reforms. Let's speak with the Minister of State for Petroleum Resources.
When I came here,
this situation significantly led to extreme problems.
The breakdown of the amount established to have been stolen and laundered.
What the federal government is doing is to provide.
When you came on board, you had a strategic master plan. To what extent have you been able to achieve the master plan to improve the oil sector in Nigeria?
Our strategic master plan, as we came in, was structured around mandates that were given to us. As we came in, we were given 9 mandate areas, and we structured our strategy around these mandate areas. And as we speak, we have been able to tick all the boxes. We've been able to achieve all our mandates. Some of them have been conclusively achieved. Some of them are still ongoing. But we've been able to touch every mandate that has been given to us. We passed the PIB to law. That was one of the mandate areas that was given to us. So that is 100% behind us. The passage of the Inland Basin Bill was also a mandate area. That was also passed very early in my tenure as minister. The marginal fields program, commercialization of flare gas, also concluded. And of course, one of the other mandate areas was also the rehabilitation of refineries. We've been able to start the rehabilitation of our refineries. That is still ongoing. The other mandate area was how to curb smuggling of petroleum products. We've also been able to put measures that are stopping this activity, not conclusively. So we have been able to tick all the boxes so far. And for now, what we are trying to do is to now create new areas for us, like new frontiers for us to conquer. For example, the introduction of auto gas for our cars was not part of the mandate areas, but that is really now our focus. And also deepening the penetration of gas so that households, more households will be using gas as cooking fuel is also something that we decided to achieve, and we are also focused there. It was not also part of our mandate area. So we've been able to touch everything that was given to us as mandate, and we have also, in addition, created additional mandates that we hope to achieve before the end of our tenure.
Now, the Senate has commended the NNPC for anti-corruption efforts drive and towards profitability. How were you able to achieve this?
Of course, it's by trying to ensure that we entrench transparency in the activities of NNPC. In 44 years of existence, this is the first time the NNPC is declaring profit. And that was because we were able to entrench a lot of transparency into our activities. And that has been able to pay off.
Let's look at petroleum pricing. The major challenge is the prices never come down. And there is a likelihood that pump price of petroleum products are likely going to come up. So, Honorable Minister, can you tell us what is the ministry doing with regards to making sure the price of petroleum products come down for Nigerians? Is there any hope for this?
I don't know if that is our mandate. What we are saying under the PIA regime is that petroleum product will be sold according to what the market dictates. And therefore, we are not in position to determine the price anymore. What we want to do is to deregulate. Once we deregulate, that means to take out subsidy. It will be the market forces that will determine the prices. And that will be a function of demand and supply. We expect that with a lot of supply, then of course the price might come down. But it will be a function of demand and supply. And that is the way we want to go, because that is what the law stipulates. We cannot now say we are going to try to bring down price of petroleum product. But what we want to do, in addition to deregulation, is to introduce another kind of fuel, the gas for cars, which is, of course, gas is a cheaper fuel. So we expect that people will now have a choice, either to drive their cars with petrol or to drive the cars with gas.
Looking at policy formulation and implementation, to what extent can the laws put in place actually bring about that revolutionary change in the Nigerian petroleum industry?
Well, we believe that the law will definitely enable that revolutionary change, as you put it. But of course, you know, as law, by itself, it cannot enable it. It is the implementation of the law. And that's why we are really focused now on implementing that law and ensuring that that law is entrenched. And I believe that with that, nobody can come tomorrow and reverse it.
What are those major challenges you faced and you think you've been able to surmount?
Well, I don't know if we have been able to surmount all the challenges, but one of the challenges that I faced, and you referred to it variously, is the issue of insecurity, especially of our crude oil. It's a sad thing. The country makes a lot of investment and produces crude, and that crude does not all get to the tank. It's a major challenge that we are still tackling, and I'm hoping that at the end of my time as minister, we would have been able to surmount it, because it is sad. It is not something I would like to hand over to another administration.
Now, let's look at the issue of human capacity development in the petroleum industry. What are those major building blocks and policies you've been able to put in place to increase the professional capacity of the workforce?
Luckily, we've always had the Petroleum Training Development Fund, the PTDF, and its core mandate is to develop capacity. What we have done is to sharpen the PTDF to be able to play that, perform that function. The NCDMB also is already in place to be able to develop local capacity. And I can tell you that, especially during the COVID-19, we've been able to really use that platform of COVID-19 to build a lot of local capacity. You know, during COVID-19, which was also one of those challenges that we faced, a lot of the expats went back to their countries because all countries were on lockdown. So we had that challenge of how to operate this industry as Nigeria. And we had to rise up to that challenge by trying to develop our local capacity. And we've been able to achieve that to a very large extent.
So how will you describe your experience as the Minister of State for Petroleum?
It's been a very interesting time. I see myself as one of the most fortunate ministers of petroleum, because I find myself at a cusp, changing from one regime to the other, and me seeing from the other side, and now going to see the beginning of a new era in the oil industry. I think no other petroleum minister before me has enjoyed this opportunity.